Hello, welcome to Kitchen Quarantine. That's the second episode. Today we're gonna realize a fish dish. So we're gonna use some fillet of bassa, and then for the garnish, we're gonna use some ingredients that maybe you have home, because you when you buy usually it's like in big quantity. It's like a celery. So we're gonna use just one celery stick, maybe you have leftover from another preparation, leek, and one potato. But let's start. So that's our ingredients. Let's start first washing all of them. So we're gonna use the green part for the puree. I want nice and green. This we're gonna use like a element as a garnish. And we from the potato we're gonna get some garnish, and as well we're gonna be in our puree. Okay, we start from the leek. I took some little bit, some leaves. I want them chiffonade, they're gonna use that garnish. So I'm gonna make very nice angle, very, very, very thin. If you don't know how to do chiffonade, it's just very thin line, thin slice, 0.5 millimeter or 1 millimeter, you know? It depends what's your technique, like how good you are, and how sharp is your knife. Just need some practice, but that's what I want. That's raw leek. It's not very nice to eat like this, so I'm gonna quick blanch it and ice it down. Roughly chop your leek. It's gonna be in our puree. I'm gonna cook the last one because I want that is cooling down very quick and it's gonna keep a nice green color. I'm gonna add as well some celery. Usually when you buy supermarket it's a big bunch, so it's gonna work very well with the fish. So clean down, roughly chop, and it's gonna go on with our puree. So we have our leek. This is actually a very nice part of it. Just wash it. Salt and pepper, oil, we're gonna place in the tray. And I'm gonna put the oven at 180-200 degrees. I want it's gonna caramelize all outside, but inside it's gonna be still al dente, but make sure you cook all the way through. So I blanch all my veg, I cut all the veg. I keep the liquid that I use for blanching, because it became a little bit like a stock. It took like flavor from the leek, from the small pieces of potato. I just melt some butter, add my diced potato, the trimming from the garnish. I let it take a little bit of flavor from the butter. Add some salt. I add my celery as well. So this is gonna cook very, very fast, because it's all diced very thin, all small pieces. Now that you see it's sizzling, you go to the next step. Now add some garlic. I add the garlic at the last one, because I don't want it to burn. Just let it down easy. It's already very nice. I cover with our thick veg stock. So we need from the leftover blanching. Not a lot of water, I just enough to cover them, so they're gonna cook through. With the high fire, let's reduce everything, let's make sure it doesn't stuck. And then we're gonna add our leek and blend it. So you prove it inside, if it's coming out in out easily, it means it's cooked all the way through. It's nice and charred. So now let's let it cool down a little bit and we cut it. Okay, our puree is nice reduced, it's cooked all the way through. I just gonna add a spoon of butter and some extra flavor. I add as well all the trimmings from our leek. Gonna leave like as well the charred flavor. Now
Let's go and blend it.
So now the our puree is ready. I keep it warm. I got my fish ready. I clarify some butter, because I'm just gonna fry in the pan with the clarified butter. So you take just from the top, you don't want the fat. So clarified butter, it goes to reach very, very high temperature. As you see, the pan is nice and hot, and I want the part of the fish that is with the center. Now, just a little bit. So I'm gonna cook in the pan with the butter until it gets nice and golden. So this is my dish for today. Let me know if you like it. Try it on. If you add something else, if you have any question. And thanks for watching. Please follow Kitchen Quarantine on Instagram and YouTube. Thanks for the sponsor of Core. And stay safe.